And one other thing that we want to do today is we have a slideshow, a multimedia presentation. This is a slideshow of slides that I got from the web, pictures having to do with spirituals, African-American spirituals, which is what the concert's about today. And just a word or two for the few people here that don't know us very well. Norma and I have been performing together for about 25 years, and we started doing arrangements of Norma's repertoire, basically, back pretty much at the very beginning of our collaboration. And now we have about 400 some pieces that we've arranged for us. We have pretty much every kind of music known to man, and we like to tell the children when we go to schools that we're the world's smallest opera company. She's all the roles, and I'm the orchestra. And I've arranged all of her stuff, basically all of her piano and orchestra parts down to flute. So I really enjoy that. It's a lot of fun. And today I'm going to announce every number, every spiritual that we do, and the original arranger, but all the things that you'll hear are basically, we boil down from the larger parts down to two voices. And so I think I want to give it to you, and you can add something to that.
Yes. The African-American spirituals that we know today have come from the tradition of the slaves. Slaves, when they were brought from Africa, were not necessarily Christian, but in the southern states where they were held, they were introduced to Christianity. And because their lives were so bad, they saw this new thing, this Christian belief, as being something that they could really kind of hang their hat on and gravitate toward, because it gave them a view of an afterlife and some happiness past where they were living. Many of them did not speak English when they came to America, they learned English as they were going along, so the language is very broken. So you can hear some of that in the dialect that is used. Some of the phrasing in some of the songs is not what we would say these days. When we were doing some of these spirituals in France once, a friend asked about a phrase that was in a song, and I was explaining it to him. And so when we were practicing a few days ago, I mentioned that to Richard, and I said, "Do you remember?" And he said, "Yeah, but then there's one phrase I was thinking about. Could you explain it to me?" And so I'll tell you about what that song is when we get there. But some of the songs are quite mournful. It shows their unhappiness and their dread. Some of them are quite joyful because they are, even though they are living in a way that they really despise, they are hoping for something better. So if it seems like some of these songs get a little bit too mournful, just hold on. We'll have some happy ones later. Okay.
And so the first spiritual that we're going to perform is entitled, "Oh, What a Beautiful City," which was originally arranged by Edward Boatner. ropes, and I don't know, you might be taking notes, trying to figure out who's coming across there. But it's a mix of, I guess, the civil rights struggle, successful black singers, artists, mm-hmm. and other...
Composers.
Composers, too, yeah. Some of the composers from this program. The next a piece that we're going to play is entitled My Lord, What a Mornin', that was arranged by Harry T. Burley.
This is the piece that Richard asked. The phrase, it's, Oh Lord, what a morning. And in part of the song, we're talking about, done quit all my worldly ways, John, which means join, that heavenly band. But then later it says, Oh Lord, what a morning, when the stars begin to fall. And he says, now what does that mean, when the stars begin to fall? And I said, it means when you die, you're done with all of your work, and there is a greater life in the next life, or in heaven. My Lord, what a morning.
time to perform is entitled Sometimes I Feel Like a Motherless Child, which was originally arranged by H.T. Burley.
This song has really a very, very deep meaning because, as I said, some of the slaves had really most of them had a horrible life, but families were separated. And there were, since they were properties of the slave owners, many children were not raised by their parents because if the owner of the plantation decided to sell a slave, he would sell that slave whether it was a child or if it was a mother who had children left, and it was not guaranteed that he would sell the whole family. So this is really, anyone can feel like a motherless child at times, but this was very literal in a way for a lot of the people who were living at that time. So we'll do Sometimes I Feel Like a Motherless Child.
Sometimes I feel like a motherless child.
persuasion have used spirituals in their concerts through the years. Marian Anderson, Paul Robeson,
Jesse
Norman, Kathleen Battle, Eric Owens, Leonard Brownlee, many of them. And it is a way of keeping the spirituals alive. Many of the African-American composers who were classically trained arranged and rearranged spirituals. Some of them wrote songs in spiritual manner, but they also took spirituals that were of the traditional type and made them their own. The tunes are pretty much the same, but they would harmonize them in different ways. So for classical musicians of African-American persuasion, the spirituals have been something that has been kind of traditionally carried down from one generation to the next. I remember as, growing up, I heard lots and lots of spirituals, of course. Since my mother, in addition to being a public school music teacher, she was also a church musician. So I was around spirituals a lot. But I didn't, when I decided to go to university, I didn't do spirituals in my undergraduate study. But when I went to my master's program, my voice teacher said, you know, you need to make sure that you have a lot of spirituals in your repertoire so that you can be part of the tradition of other African-American opera singers. And I said, well, I love spirituals. I have done some, but I don't have a large amount of the solo repertoire. And so from that time on, I started building and building and building, and so I've done spiritual concerts and then also added them on concerts that I, normal European music, arias and art songs of other countries. Some of these, if you haven't heard, some you may have heard some of these spirituals in recordings. Folk musicians tend to take these spirituals and perform them. And of course, Christian musicians do, Christian singers. But spirituals have also been used in movies. I remember as a child looking at a movie that some of people who are adults here might remember. You may not remember, or you may not remember. But Imitation of Life. Do you remember that movie, anyone here? It was a movie I saw as a kid. We actually bought a copy recently. And it has Mahalia Jackson singing Nobody Knows the Trouble I've Seen in this movie. So the spirituals have gotten into various arts that we have, movies and in shows. And so you don't always have to be in a concert hall or listening to a recording by a Christian artist in order to hear them.
And the gentleman that just left the screen was the arranger of the next number. That was Hal Johnson, and the next number would be Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
Come in for the cure.
Because the slave owners didn't want them congregating among themselves because they thought they might be figuring out some way to revolt. So many of them, they didn't have pianos or organs or guitars to have their little services with. They only had their voices. So we like to do just a little bit of a cappella singing and reminiscing of those times.
And so the next spiritual that we're going to perform was arranged originally by Paul Johnson, who you've seen a few times perhaps already here, and it's called Witness.
O Lord, what manner of man is this? All knees and seeing him are blessed. All things are done by his will. He spoke to the sea and the sea stood still. Now ain't that a witness for my Lord? Ain't that a witness for my Lord? Ain't that a witness for my Lord? The sun
interesting piece, because in the spiritual tradition you have call and response, and then you have these percussive type pieces. And I often think when I'm doing this one, I have lately, well, this is about as close to hip-hop or rap than I'll ever get. So there it was. You were here to witness it.
And I was doing the percussion with knocking knees. So, let's see. Any questions? Well, we do an equipment check here. The next number we're going to do is entitled City Called Heaven, which was arranged also by Hal Johnson. He must have arranged half of the numbers we've done, probably.
He's a wonderful composer. He was really quite prolific. And for classical singers, his arrangements are really, really good for solo songs. He actually, during his lifetime, had a choir that he traveled with, and they performed only spirituals. But his arrangements are really, really wonderful.
And William Grant Still, who just fled off the screen there, was actually, we almost met him. Well, we know his family. When we first met, we went out to get some music from them, some of his manuscripts. And
in Flagstaff, Arizona.
Yeah. So this is City Called Heaven.
Ooh!
not looking over our shoulder. This one is entitled "His Name So Sweet," originally arranged by Hal Jones.
This one goes pretty fast, so I have to check my head out.
Yeah!
titled Ride On, Ride On, not Right On, King Jesus, also arranged by Hal Jones.
Yeah.
next number is by William Grant Still, who came by a little while ago. And he did quite a few spirituals himself, and we took two and put them together and made a spiritual medley out of them. The first one's entitled Here's One, and the second one is called Listen to Dee Lambs.
Yeah.
number today, and it's entitled He's Got the Whole World in His Hands, arranged by Margaret Bonds. She was on there a few minutes ago, probably. And a piece of housekeeping, you can exit this door. You don't have to go down the luge run, otherwise known as 17 or 9 or whatever, or stairway, code. And unless you have brought your rain jackets with you, but I don't think any good yet. But it hasn't rained, we've been truly blessed.
Oh, yes.
And it'll start the minute you leave the house. I can guarantee. So, because we've been praying real hard. And his, so.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, you go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
Okay. So, He's Got the Whole World in His Hands is the last number. Arranged by Margaret Bonds.
Yes, and Margaret Bonds is one of the most famous of all the African-American women composers, and one of the early ones that was actually recognized as being a great composer. I really like doing this piece because it sums up what we all want, and that is that he's got the whole world in his hands, and we're all going to be okay. He's got the whole world in his hands. 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 He's got the woods and the waters in his hands. He's got the woods and the waters in his hands. He's got the sun and the moon right in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the birds and the bees right in his hands. He's got the birds and bees right in his hands. He's got the beast of the field right in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the love and the beard in his hands. He's got the love and the beard right in his hands. He's got the love and the beard in his hands.
Barbara Conrad, and as her brother, they're homies of Norma, basically, from East Texas.
From East Texas.
Yes, exactly. Barbara Conrad, Metropolitan Opera, mezzo-soprano. So anyway, thank you for coming, and hopefully we won't get much rain anymore this week.